Okay, this video is about electrocyclic reactions under photochemical conditions. So this is as opposed to the thermal conditions. I've got a video about those showing how, for example, a hexatriene will undergo a thermal cyclization via a dysrotatory process to give a cis substituted compound if we have these two E double bonds. Now, if we take the same molecule and we shine UV light on it, then we actually get the opposite diastereochemistry, or the opposite diastereochemical configuration. So we get the trans compound. So why is that the case? Okay, well, it comes down to the fact that under photochemical conditions, we're going to change what is the HOMO. We're always interested in the HOMO for the electrocyclic reaction. And in the case of photochemical conditions, we take the ground state here, we shine UV light on it, and we're going to promote an electron from what was the HOMO up to what was the LUMO. Now, in the excited state, the new HOMO is going to be what was the old LUMO. So this is going to be the HOMO. Now, if we had a look at our molecular orbital diagrams from before, we know that the old HOMO had this arrangement of the phases of the constituent atomic orbitals, and we had two nodes. And that meant that at either end that is undergoing the electrocyclic process, we're going to have to do a dysrotatory process to get the two orbitals to come into a favorable interaction. However, in the excited state, we're now talking about an orbital that was the LUMO. So this had a different symmetry. It had this arrangement here, where we had three nodes. So we had a node here, there, and there. And so that's going to change our arrangement of orbitals when we look at how the two ends are going to come together. So let's put that diagram onto our 3D arrangement of the molecule here. So we'll start off here, these two in phase, those two in phase with each other, like that. So now the two ends of the molecule that are coming together to make the new sigma bond are in opposite phase. So once again, I've got a model for this. So I've got a model of the hexatriene with that new excited state HOMO shown, and these red atoms signifying the methyl groups. Okay, so for this molecule to get the two end atoms to come into bonding arrangement, we have to get one to rotate in one direction and then the other to rotate in the same direction. So if one goes clockwise, the other must go anti-clockwise, and that will give us that bonding arrangement. And now we've got the two methyl groups on opposite sides of the ring. So hopefully you can see that. And it doesn't matter whether they both go in a clockwise or they both go in an anti-clockwise direction. We just need them both to give constructive overlap at the ends of the molecule. This gets a bit fiddly with these models. But in either direction, we're going to get the trans diastereomer of the product. Okay? Now, if we go both clockwise, we're going to get one enantiomer. If we make them go both anti-clockwise, we'll get the opposite enantiomer. And because I've got a chiral starting material here, they're both equally energetically favorable, so we'll get both enantiomers in equal amounts, and so we'll get a racemic mixture. Okay, so we're going to get rotation around this bond in one direction, and then this bond is going to rotate around in the same direction.
This is known as a conrotatory process.
And that's how we're going to get these two methyl groups to be on opposite sides of the ring. So if they're like this, and we rotate this way, they're going to be opposite sides to give that enantiomer. Whereas if they rotate the opposite way, but still in the same direction, we're going to get the opposite enantiomer. So we'll get this molecule plus its enantiomer. Okay. Where we have this methyl group down and this methyl group up. Now, quite often you'll see, because we recognize it as organic chemists, that acyclic molecules in an achiral environment will give equal amounts of enantiomers, you quite often see just one of these drawn, or possibly plus EN for enantiomer or plus enantiomer. But whatever the case, recognize that where we have an achiral molecule in an achiral environment, we're going to get equal amounts of the two enantiomers. But under these photochemical conditions, we will get only the trans diastereomer. Okay, so that's electrocyclic reactions under photochemical conditions.